declare something tonight. Say they're going to release a prophetic word over your life. You're going to declare for yourself. And yet at the same time for the body of Christ. It's really simple.
Can you hear the voice of the Father inviting you to walk on the water? Risk it all. Answer the call. Now we stand on every promise. We're not afraid. Our faith goes before us. When we believe, we want to see the supernatural.
Do you believe it? Do y'all believe it? I need to know if y'all believe it. Yes, sir. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on, come on, good morning. Come on, tell somebody. Welcome to the EDU 8 a.m. experience. This is your morning dynamic devotion and prayer. You need prayer. You need some devotion. You might as well come on and join in with us. Come on, somebody. Send your hearts up. Send the hands up. Let's give God praise this morning. Can you bless him this morning, y'all? I missed you. I missed you. I appreciate you. I know y'all was wondering what was going on. COVID was going on. Oh, but we made it. We literally can say a lot of people didn't make it, but he saw fit. Come on, IG, how y'all this morning? Good morning. I love good morning. Good morning. Come on, Facebook. Good morning. YouTube. Good morning. Good morning. Callers. Come on. Good morning. Good morning. Come on, I'm going to hold you here a bit. I don't have a whole lot of new words for you and those things, but boy, I tell you what, ready to go. Text somebody, call somebody, let them know you're here. Let's go. We're in our 21-day 523 fast. 523 fast is the first week. We worked out body. That's where we did a quarter Murph. You ran a half a mile. Then you did 25 pull-ups, 50 push-ups, 75 air squats, 100 jumping jacks, and then you did another half mile. All right, we did that every day. That was 7 days. Did that every day the first week. The second week, we came off just now, the second week, where there is no entertainment, no music. No, can I listen to worship music? Stop playing. No entertainment. Now, that's the hard week because the flesh, boy, desires those things. No, your YouTube, your Facebook, your television, especially for those of you, like I said, the music. But here's the thing. It's working on the soul. The soul, because when you feed your soul, when you're feeding your soul, your emotions, all those things rise and grow. And so here's what we do, Laplace, Louisiana. Here's what we do. Come on, Tam. This is what we do. We abstain from those things because when we fast, we're feeding our spirit, which is this week, our spirit, and our spirit is liquids only. We're denying the body. We're abstaining from food. This is a true biblical fast to abstain from food for a time of spiritual refreshing, spiritual renewal. And we use Matthew, the 6th chapter, as our prayer fasting and giving, because at the end of the fast, we sow a seed. During the fast, we pray the entire time. Matthew 6, read it and you will see it. The 5:23 fast comes from 1 Thessalonians 5:23. I pray that your whole body, your soul, and your spirit be preserved blameless. So you are tripartite in existence. Therefore, we work on all three parts of man during the fast. Anybody following this me this morning? Come on. We work in this thing. And so the first Monday of every year, just as we do the first Monday in August, we spend 21 days fasting after the pattern that most are using, which is the Daniel 21 days, three full weeks. I ate no great, no sweet thing, nothing good, basically, that was tasty. That's what it was. Okay, so I've given you the preliminary, I've given you the structure, I've given you the system, and I've given you the spiritual. And so I wasn't coming back till February. Y'all a trip. You better tell somebody. Will, you're a trip. Jimmy Rollins, you're a trip. All y'all a trip. Let me tell you why y'all a trip. All right. Here's the reason why, Denise. Listen to me. The reason why is because I said it's only liquids this week and you tripped out. You better come back here. But y'all brought me back in. So the spiritual week, I'm here because you can give away the structure. You can give away the systems, but the spiritual component can't give that away. So I'm here with you for the spiritual. Are y'all ready? Come on. Moya is here. I'm telling y'all, let's go this morning. So every day we give you inspiration that's coming out of the Word of God, which is the inspired word. So coming out of the Word of God. Let me slow down. I know my wife is saying slow down, babe. All right, let me slow down. We give you inspiration that's coming out of the Word of God. I'm just excited to be with y'all. I love y'all. Irma, I love y'all. All right. Then we give you motivation, or rather, we give you an application so that you can enact, you can walk out the word that you just studied this morning. And then we give you motivation. What do you need in order to be motivated to fulfill the inspiration that you had? So we have the inspiration and we have the motivation. But you're responsible to carry out the application. Amen. Listen, love you this morning. If you have a prayer request, put it on the wall. We say that we're on the wall as if we're in the city of Jerusalem itself, where they're praying on the wall and they insert their prayer requests and they believe that God is going to answer them. And so we're using technical data, and we ask you to put your prayer request on the wall. Those of you on IG, put your prayer request in the comments. Those of you that are on YouTube, make a comment and put your prayer request there. And then I'm asking myself or someone from our prayer team, these are trained people and or people that are with us regionally around the world. They're called our EDU prayer ambassadors. They will pray for your prayer right there on the wall. Now, if you believe that your prayer request is a little bit more private in nature, you can click on the link there. They're on Facebook, they're on YouTube, and or go to our website at amazingchurch.com. Click on the prayer request component, and then someone will get back with you within 24 to 48 hours. All of our responses happen within 24 to 48 hours, and so we're not going to leave you out there. We're not going to leave you alone. We absolutely love you. We absolutely believe in the power of prayer, that every answer is found in the Word of God. My goodness. All right. So this morning, I don't have for you a breakdown of the inspiration or a breakdown with the motivation, but I do have an app for you today. And I'm going to give you your app up front. All right. The reason why I'm giving your app up front is because I want you to have the proper expectation of what I'm about to read this morning. Glory to God. Woo, here's what it is. You ready? Here's your app today. Somebody say, see, now for those of you that have been here, or those of you that are new, thank y'all so much for being with us. Typically, I'll go with the inspiration. I say, somebody say ready, and they'll put on ready, and then we'll go into ready. Then we'll go through the inspiration, the Word of God, the scripture that we're studying. Then I'll give you the motivation, which is the breakdown of that scripture. After the breakdown, then I'll say, somebody say today, and then people will say today, and today means that you're ready for the app, all right? So Eternity, are you ready for the app today? All right, here's your application. Here's your application right there. That's your app today. Today, stand on the promise of God. Today, stand on the promise of God. Today, Stand on the promise of God. What promise? The promise that he will deliver. Stand on the promise. What promise? The promise that he will never leave nor forsake. What promise? The promise, those of us that love him and obey him, we will see him in the soon and very soon, the by and the by, when he cracks the sky and comes and gives. What's the promises of God? The promises of God is that the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. What's the promise of God? All the promises of God are yes and amen. And so, to emphasize your application on today, I have a passage of scripture that I'm going to read, which will correlate with a passage of scripture that I already broke down for you. If you're with me this morning, say, I'm standing on his promise. Promises. Are you ready? All right, so I'm going to read to you Acts, the 12th chapter, verse number 11. And I'm going to read it to you, just this verse, but I want you to get the entire thing of Acts 12 as it pertains to Peter and the people praying in the house. Are you ready? Verse 11 says this. It says, and when Peter had come to himself, he said, now I know for certain the Lord has sent his angel and has delivered me from the hand of Herod and from all the expectation of the Jewish people. Let me read it again. Okay, read it again. Ready? It says, and when Peter had come to himself. Now, last time we heard about somebody coming to themselves, that was the prodigal son. He was out in the hog pen, and scripture says when he came to himself, he realized that his father's servants were doing better than what he was doing. And he was entitled to the house. He said, well, if I just go and just be with the servants, are you following? Here it is. Peter says, but he can't come to himself because Peter was in prison, was bound. An angel came and said, hey, listen, get up, put on your garments, let's go. And walk through a gate. Walk, listen, Jesus is not the only one that walked through a wall, walked through a door. Peter did this as well with this angel. And so there's a powerful thing that's happening to him. That overcame him. And Peter, when he had come to himself, after he had gone through all, he said, Lord, have mercy. Look at me. I'm out. I'm free. I was inbound. I was going down. All right. Listen, come on, stand on his promises, Marsha. This is what he said. He was praying. No, it said the people were praying in a house. So here's the promise of God. He will hear you and he will answer to you. You will cry out to him and he will show you great and mighty things. And for us, come on, church, come on. Listen to me, for us, the power of our intercession will set the captive free. We've got to understand that these principles, these things that we see in scripture, though we're not going, may not be able to, we don't know, that's up for us to have the faith to believe, that we can pray somebody through walls. This man here was innocent. This man here was called by God to deliver. This man for the people in the house. And get this, when Peter came to himself, he says, I know for certain the Lord has sent his angel. When he gets to the house, the people, he knocks on the door. Rhoda comes to the door and says, wait a minute. What we have been praying for has shown up. Are y'all getting this morning? I'm standing on his promises that what he said he will do. What I'm praying for, I'm going to see. So what do we do? What do we say? We say that, listen, when do you stop praying for what you're believing for? When I see the manifestation of what I've been praying for. Now, listen, they saw the manifestation and then they were astonished. Now, why were they astonished? Because for so long, it appears that they were praying for the Messiah. For so long, they were looking for something to happen. For so long, they've been believing, but they didn't walk away from God, but they didn't have the faith to believe that what God promised, which is that he will hear and that he will answer. This is New Testament. That was something that was said in Jeremiah in the Old Testament. What they believed was going to come to pass. And when it came to pass, it was so overwhelming that she couldn't receive the promise. She closed the door, went in and made the announcement. God has done what he said he would do. And they told her, you're crazy because God doesn't come through. Well, I'm here to tell you today. I'm here to tell you this morning. I'm here to get you ready this morning to stand on the promises of God. If God said that you shall live and not die, don't focus on dying, focus on living. If he said that he will hear you and that he will answer you, don't stop praying. Regardless of how long it is, don't stop praying because you're going to see what you've been praying for. So I read that. I gave you that. I gave you that story, and they celebrated. They were great. Peter went into the house and told them, listen, all well. They were touching on him. All is well. Great glory. Now go tell John. Go tell John that God delivered. I didn't die in there. You don't have to die in the, you don't have to die in a space where it looked like God is, it looked like God is not hearing you. God, somebody's praying for you. My wife and I, while we were fighting with COVID, I said, I could feel when the saints was praying. And I could also feel when the saints got tired. Listen, you can't get tired here because we got promises. All right, so now I gave y'all the stand on the promises. I gave y'all that. Come on. I gave Aaliyah, I give you this. And here's what else I want to give you. I want to remind you that the 22nd will be here, January 22nd will be here. You need to have some expectation about some things. Because he said he will crown your year, Psalm 65 and 11. He will crown the year. He will crown the year. Come on. Listen, I had no intentions of going through corona, even though I know this word corona is corona, but means crown. Does not mean this word corona here does not mean virus. So don't try to make that something it's not. All right. But this means that he will crown. Now, there is an understanding of these things and how they happen. Yes. But he will bring it full circle and bless. We said we didn't know if it was end of the year or if it was starting the year. But we do know this, that October the 22nd, that was the last or the end of the year, those 3 months, crown, all right? And we see, come on, come here. We see that this would mean that for us in the spirit realm, that January 22nd is going to be the end of the year and the start of a new one. Y'all ready? Okay. So he says, you're going to crown the year with your goodness, with his kindness, and your past, his ways. Those of us that are entrenched in his ways, he says that that's where his abundance will flow, will drip, it will distill. He will remove all of the ugly. He will remove all of the impurities. He will remove it all, and you will be left with the best part, y'all. So God will bring the year to full and bless it with his kindness and generosity. And as we are entrenching ourselves in his ways, he will remove all the impurities and bring forth an abundance in our lives. Somebody, come on, entrench, stay entrenched. Do not get caught up in the drama. We said that. Don't get caught up. And if anybody knows what I'm talking about, since October to January 22nd, there's a whole lot of drama in there. Do not get caught up. Have the expectation that God is going to crown the year with his goodness and kindness, and his paths will drip with abundance. That is your expectation, y'all. It's about to happen on the 22nd at 8 p.m. I will be on here and tell you what the Lord gave me that I could not deliver earlier or prior to. I can't tell you why, but I will tell you this. I'm going to obey him. And so I absolutely want to tell y'all, somebody give God praise for it. That's your inspiration. Acts, the 12th chapter, verse number 11, Psalm 65 and 11. That's your motivation. Listen, we can't get caught up in the drama and the distractions. We must entrench our ways in the ways of the Lord. We got to chase him. We got to follow him. Your application today is stand on the promises of God. And don't you move until you see what you been praying for. Absolutely. Come on. Are y'all standing? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. If you believe it, come on, give him praise for it. If you believe it, give him praise for it. Come on, IG. Come on, Facebook. Come on, YouTube. Give him praise for it. We're about to pray, but I need you to give him glory for it. You're standing on the promises of God. Our God, he is God. Come on, our God, he's a great God. Our God is not slack concerning his promise. Our God, in the midst of all things, when there is no hope, our God is our hope. Come on. Our God, he is God. There's none like him, none beside him, none. You understand me? Come on. Everybody's tried to dog him. Everybody's tried to doubt him. Many they have tried to replace him, but they can't, because our God has stood the test of time. There is only one God that has stood the test of time. There's only one God that always tries to get doubted. There's only one God that they try to discredit. There's only one God that they try to dethrone, but they can't dethrone him. He is our God. He is the greatest, and there will be none like him. There was none before him. He created the heavens and the earth, and when the earth was without form, that same God spoke into existence the firmament out of the midst of the waters and told the waters to pull back and not to go any further. That same God spoke into place the planet, that the green herbs and the herbs on the planet were growing, caused trees to come out the ground and brushes and bushes and the green herbs to come forth. The herbs. What is that so important? Because God did it all before he ever put man in the planet, before an animal was ever here, before there was ever the thought of the cataclysmic concoction of an explosion that all life forms came out. No, God spoke that. In other words, you need to understand that you are a promise that came out of the mouth of God, and he spoke you to existence. And here today, you ought to give him praise that you are a promise in the planet that God called to be. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Hallelujah. Father, we bless you this morning. We thank you this morning. You're worthy this morning. You've always been God and you have never resigned. You've always been God and you've never changed. We thank you that you're faithful and that you're true, that you're consistent and that you're constant. We understand the breakthrough is on the other side of consistency. And so we thank you, Lord God, that you've given us a mind to serve you, that you've given us a mind to focus on you, that you've given us a mind to align ourselves with your word. Lord, we are entrenched in your ways. We're not just saying yes to salvation, God, but we're saying yes, we're obedient in and to your word. And because we are obedient in and to your word, may we experience perpetual increase in prosperity. Your word says that some plant, some water, but God, it is you that gives the increase. And so our expectation, our desire, God, is to please you, Father, and to fulfill your expectation of us here in the planet. We understand that you have given us purpose and that you give us the reason. There is a cause, and that cause, God, is to fulfill the expansion of the kingdom of you, God, your kingdom here, your desire, because your word says, let your kingdom come and let your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. God, bring heaven to earth by our desire to please you. Bring heaven to earth by our obedience to your word. Bring heaven to earth, God, by our worship. We will cry out to you, God, that you will show yourself strong and mighty. We come against all of the wicked schemes of the enemy. We bind every attack of the wicked one. Your word says there are two or three are gathered together, there you will be in the midst. We have an expectation, God, that because we have come together as like-minded believers, that Jesus, you are here. Lord, we give you thanks, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Thank you for dying for us. Thank you for shedding your blood. Thank you for carrying our sins. Thank you for resurrecting yourself, and that we have the expectation of resurrection ourselves when we shall leave this old earthen vessel. And we shall meet you in the sky. We give you praise, God. We give you glory for the promise that you, God, will not leave us here. That you, God, will not forsake us. That you, God, will not put us in a position, Lord God, that you will not make a way of escape. That you will not leave us ignorant to the enemy's devices. That everything, God, that we believe we receive at the time we pray, that we shall receive those things that pertain to life and godliness. God, we bless you this morning. Thank you, Lord. We woke up this morning with the intent to give you glory. We woke up this morning with the intent to give you praise. We bind the enemy and everything that he would say, every word, every whisper, everything that he would try to present to us to show us, God, that for some reason and somehow you won't show up. But God, since you know respect of persons, what you do for one in principle, you will do for another. Just like you did for them that were in the house with Rhoda praying for the deliverance of Peter. Father, we pray for the deliverance of those that we love, that you would bring them out of the bondage that sin has put them in, that you would bring them out of the murk and the mire that they seem to be stuck in, that you would deliver them out of the foolishness of their consciousness, that is worldly in its focus, God, that it would be spiritual in its focus and application. We thank you and we give you glory this morning. We pray because we believe that we receive. We pray because we know that you hear us and that you will answer us. We pray, God, and intercede on behalf of those that need it. God, those that are living in a form of godliness, that are proclaiming your name but are full of sin, God, deliver them, God. Radically change their mind. Let them come to their senses. Send an angel to speak to them, to put on the garment of praise, to put on the garment of worship, to walk out your word, God, to have a radical transformation, knowing, God, that they've got to give their lives fully to you, because we've seen, God, over time, people are good at saying, God, I love you, but their heart, God, is a hard thing to walk it out. Help them walk it out. Give them ease on their journey. Give them prosperity in their desire to please you. Father, we thank you this morning. We ask that you would heal those that need healing now, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. We ask, God, that if it's not their time, they would tell the spirit of death, this death angel, that you've got to pass over. God, you did it for the children, the Hebrews that were entrapped in Egypt. God, now do it for those that may be trapped in something else. God, deliver them. Remove the coronavirus. God, we ask that you continue not just to flatten it, but to eradicate it and eliminate it. God, however you're going to do it, whether you will do it through medicine, we give you thanks. Whether you will do it through miracle, we give you thanks. Whether you would do it, Father God, in a way that people have not expected, we come against it now. We're not going to stop because we believe what we've been praying for. We thank you, Lord God, that you make supernatural provision. Send provision. Somebody is in need of provision, Lord God. Send supernatural provision in Jesus' name, Lord. Secure. Remove the anxiety of whether or not someone's going to keep their job. Right now, God, eliminate that panic, that moment, that panic attack where they're thinking they're going to lose their job. God, secure them and strengthen them. God, businesses that are starting, let them not start and stop or stutter, but let them start, God, and have prosperity in the starting of it. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for those that have lost loved ones along the way. Help us to be those that have a hope. Help us to be those that have an understanding. Help us, God, to mourn with them while they're mourning. But God, we bind this desire to grieve so that it can fulfill some kind of prophecy. But we have an expectation that you will move them along the process, God. Move them along the process, because Jesus carried our griefs and he bore our sorrows. Help them to find the joy, Lord God, because to live is Christ and to die is great gain. We give you blessing. We give you praise. Father, I thank you that their ears are open to hear the prophetic words that are being spoken to them in Jesus' mighty name. We give you thanks. We give you glory. We give you praise in the name of Yeshua, Jesus, our Lord, our Savior, the Christ that we are in Christ. Therefore, in Jesus, we pray. In Jesus, we give you thanks. In Jesus, we say amen. Amen. Come on, somebody, come on. Emunah, those of you that are in faith, somebody give God praise for it. Come on, somebody give him thanks for it. Come on, come on, y'all. Come on, give him glory for it. Glad to be back with y'all. I love you. If you like it, come on, do what you're supposed to do. Like, comment, share, and tag. Let's make this thing happen. God is God, and nothing can stop that. And when you get over this thing about dying and fear and anxiety and worry, when you get over that monster, that's a demon. When you get over that monster, you will realize that it's not necessary for you to spend any time in that space at any point in your life, because God is your anchor. God is your strength. Jesus is your Savior. The Holy Spirit is the wisdom of God in action. He will lead and guide you into all truth. I love y'all so much. Thank y'all so much for all of your prayers. Glad you're here this morning. Go today. Stand on the promises of God. He will not fail. He will not fail. He won't forsake. But he will. He will do this. He will come through for you. Absolutely adore you. Appreciate you. Thank y'all so much. And we'll see y'all back here tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Central Standard Time. If the Lord says the same, this is your EDU, your Everyday Until 8 a.m. Morning Dynamic Devotion and Prayer. I'm Derek Golden. Thank you so much for joining. We'll see you back here tomorrow morning. Y'all be blessed. All right. callers. Love y'all. We'll see y'all in a little bit. Hey, listen. IG. Appreciate y'all. See y'all tomorrow. Y'all be blessed. All right, y'all. Listen. Y'all YouTube and Facebook. Y'all, I'm telling you, I'm glad to see y'all. If meet me back here tomorrow morning and you need to get somebody else on with you, y'all need to stop this, all this here, praising God and all that stuff. Not being facetious, man, praise the Lord. Here's something I want to give you. Listen, your desires always need development. So make sure that you submit yourself to a place and something where you can be developed in the thing that you believe God has called you to do and to become. The distance between your deliverance and your dominion are the decisions that you will make in between. I absolutely love you. We'll see you on what? Tomorrow. Y'all be blessed.